Greetings, fellow warriors, and welcome back to another Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord Mods weekly episode. The show where I, Artem, show some of the best mods released in the past weeks, as well as some that I personally find interesting, and of course, show you exactly what each one of them does. Also, if you haven't by now, it would really make my day if you'd hit that subscribe button, since 84% of you watching this video are actually not subscribed. And the best way to show your support and join our ever-growing army, of course, is to do just that. And follow me on Instagram. This time around, we've got a little bit of everything, so let's talk no further and jump in to the mod list. Starting off with the list, we've got the Forge for Me mod by HeloKiro13. Which lets you buy forged and enhanced weapons. When visiting a town, you'll notice that there will be a new menu in place called Enter Smithy Menu, where you can choose between two other options. The first option, Forge Menu, lets you buy random forged weapons, which is just like the player crafting, but all crafting parts are randomized. There are four tiers for the forged weapon you can get: Basic, Middle, High, and Master, which are different stat-wise. The higher the tier, the higher the stats. Simple, right? The other option, Enhance Menu, lets you enhance your equipped melee weapon. You can enhance a weapon as many times as you like, but the enhancement will not stack. It will always be different. So, for example, the base stat will be the same, while the additional stat can be different every time. The mod is pretty good in my opinion, since it adds another way to create new and powerful weapons, instead of grinding the smithing skill. The only downside to it is that you sadly can't rename your weapons. So long, Nutbuster 3000, I'll never forget you. Up next we have another mod by HeloKiro13, called Race Relation with Town and Village, which, well, lets you do just what the title says. For example, you can race the relation with notables of the town or village, raise the morale of the player's party and the relation with a companion within the party, raise the power of the notables of the town or village, or raise the prosperity or food stock of said town. There was a similar feature in Warband, where you could spend 1000 dinars to buy everyone's drink who visits the tavern for the night. This raised the player's reputation with the town by one, but this offer could only be made to one town per day. I think everything that brings back some features from Warband to its successor is welcome by anyone except
these faces.
And I hope that most features like this, and breaking people free from the castle dungeon for example, will make a return in the future. Next up we have the Four Honor Weapons by BestMods168, which adds the Warden's Longsword and the Shugoki Kanabo to Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord. The two-handed longsword is a double-edged weapon. Its hilt is comprised of a long, jutting crossguard, a heavy pommel for counterbalance, and a grip wrapped in leather. In spite of its size and weight, it remains a versatile weapon, offering a balance of offense as well as defense. And the Kanabo is a traditional club so large that it takes a powerful but also skilled warrior to wield it correctly. It can deliver a crippling blow with every hit, but its weight tends to leave the user open for counterattacks if it misses. Now we only need the Shugoki and Warden armor to complete the set. Maybe someone wants to create a For Honor mod? Just maybe, you know? Just me? Oh. Up next we have the Swadian Armory mod by A Damn Sexy Name, which adds 4 different helmets, a shoulder piece and a new high tier body armor for Vlandia to Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord. Now, I know, I've covered already all the helmets from this modder, and that is very true, but this is going to be his main mod, which gets constantly updated with new stuff, so I cover it here. All the newly added items have a lot of different variations, 24 in total, like a brass face mask or different color patterns. Some items like the chest piece and the winged helmet also change their color depending on what faction color you have, opening up a whole new level of customizing your armor. The mod adds the Italo-Norman helmet in 2 variations, a fluted helmet with face mask in 4 variations, a great helmet in 5 variations, a winged great helmet and 3 variations. A Vlerdian helmet with visor in 3 variations. Suedian plated shoulders in 2 variations. And the coat of plate in 5 variations. The new items fit just so well into Bannerlord that some might think that these are official models created by a Tailwords developer, and I hope that A Damn Sexy Name will expand even more on this idea. Maybe this is going to be the biggest armor overhaul Bannerlord will ever see. Only time will tell. But for now, thank you for your hard work and keep it up. Next up we have Medieval Armor and Weapons by Enclave, which adds additional armor and weapons to the game, based off of early and late medieval artifacts and art. In its current state, the mod contains an armet, a Milanese plate armor, a poleaxe, a sallet, as well as a painted version, and Milanese gauntlets and greaves. And this is how the whole Milanese set looks like, with everything attached. It looks damn epic, and the quality is quite outstanding. I'm in no means a modeler, but for the average eye like mine, this looks fantastic. This mod deserves much more love, and the author seems to be quite the nice guy as well. Check out the mod page if you want to download the mod, and leave a nice comment in the comment section. But that's not all there is to it. The modder plans to add many weapons and armor, from early bardishes to late Milanese plate armor to mountain blade to Bannerlord. And any mod that adds more armor and especially plate armor to the game is heavily needed, in my opinion at least. And today's last mod is going to be New Equipment by Genref Poggy, which adds, well, just what the title of the mod already says. New Equipment to Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord. It adds 2 Sturgeon shoulder guards, 1 with a long cape, 2 Vlerdian full face helmets, 2 Vlerdian crowns and 1 Empire tiara. Now, before you go on and say, hey, I've already seen armor like this, this isn't new, which is technically true. Armor pieces that look like this already existed in Bannerlord, but the modder had the glorious idea to merge different armor parts together and...
it just works.
I mean, look at this. We need some variation in the equipment we already have, and I hope that the author will add even more merged meshes to the game, which opens up so many possibilities to how you want your armor to look like. And the next update is going to add 2 katanas and 1 set of samurai armor to the game, which I really do look forward to. And yeah, I guess that's it for this week's mods episode. I hope you liked it. If you did, please hit that like button. And if you like what I do in general, consider subscribing to the channel and maybe leave a nice comment. That would be pretty epic. Follow me on Instagram and join my Discord, where you can talk with me and other like-minded people about all kinds of stuff. And I see you all in the next one. Stay safe, warriors, and bye.